came here about going to school. Me, I followed them to take the common entrance. So that I knew where I came from. One thing with so many people, they don't know where they are coming from. If you can identify where you are coming from, it will determine anything you are going to do in life. So many people. That is why you will see very poor people, once they get married to rich people, they will change. They forgot where they are coming from. They will just change. Know where you are coming from, and that will help you a lot. There was one thing I made up my mind. I knew he came from a very poor home. I knew it very well. And when his friends were going abroad, this one was going there, this one was going there, but he could not go because he was there to take care of the mother and the father. Then I made up my mind. I said, when these people will come back, I was ready to stand by him. He talked so much, he cannot do everything he talked about. He will come and preach better, I will stand there to bring them to pass.
See this woman.
Because I know he can't stress him too much. I study him, he can't stress him too much. So he will talk. So I will stand by. I will make sure that when he speaks, I put them into action. And so when you come back, when you come back, because we hear him talk, then say, let us go back and see where he is. Of course, you will come and you will be surprised. Praise the Lord. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. So, that is one thing with us, women. If you get married to a man, you must check him very well. Know where he is coming from. So he might not be able to measure up with a friend. But like I said, I made up my mind. I said, none of his friends, like he said, none. None. And that was what I did in Obama, when they gave us that land. We sold part of it to train the children. When it was getting finished, I told him, we caught this man for a purpose. So, we made up, I told him, it is time to start. Because if there's a way, even my people, they saw him as a failed doctor. So I said, I'm going to surprise them. So when it was time to build that school, I made sure that if you get to that school, if you get there, it's only the result that can fool the mind of people.
Yes.
Don't talk without producing results. So, like I was saying, you must study your husband. It's not as if we don't quarrel, we quarrel a lot.
Open confession.
This one will enter this room, the other one will enter the other room. Okay, no. Then within a short while, we'll come back. And when I'm boiling, I will just pick my phone and send text to a very hot one. Then what I do, I send it to myself. I will send that message to myself. After 1 hour, I will go back and read the message, and this one will cause trouble. Then I will delete it. I will delete it. We quarrel, then we come together. Because there is no way, because nothing is outside. So, whether you quarrel or not, you must bring the food for him. You can imagine that. So, let us learn as women. Know where your husband is coming from. Because, like what we are not doing at our work, I went to when he wanted to build, he said, "I should put it in my name." I said, "No. Anything I buy is in the family's name. Because I don't want tomorrow my people will come and say, 'This belongs to my sister.' I don't have anything there. Belong to the Apokin family. So you can't go there."